Penguin Random House presents The Wisest Owl, Be Your Own Financial Planner by Anupam Gupta, read by Dev J. Haldar. This book is meant for information and education purposes only. The views expressed in this book are those of the author and of the SEBI RIAs in their interviews. No part of this book should be considered as a specific financial advice. Please do your homework and consult a professional before you take any decision. The websites of each of the six RIAs have been given in the chapters. The websites contain the contact details and readers are encouraged to reach out to them directly. The author, Anupam Gupta, can be contacted at anupam9gupta@gmail.com. For my family, my mother, Shubhra Saran, my wife, Vanita, and my son, Varun. The main thing about money, bud, it makes you do things you don't want to do. Lou Mannheim, Hal Halbrook, to Bud Fox, Charlie Sheen, Wall Street, 1987. It ain't what you don't know that gets you into trouble. It's what you know for sure that just ain't so. Opening lines from the movie The Big Short, 2015. Foreword. Change is a continuous process. You can discern a change only once in a generation. Because once you discern it, you're already there. So in these last 50 years, I can discern only two changes, but they are large because a continuous process is being focused at two or three points. The next big change will come with my son. There are spans of transition. There are much bigger spans with the succeeding generations. My son will go through a very large change in circumstances in many ways. In the family, in the school surroundings, in the job market, everywhere. I grew up in a half-ritualistic background. My son will have no ritualistic background. But if my son loses the rituals even further, he could still be rooted locally within his peer group. There will be many like him. Society is moving that way. V.S. Naipaul, A Million Mutinies Now, 1990. Very few books capture the vastness of India, let alone the diversity and the far-reaching impact of generational changes. The paragraphs quoted above are from a book written as far back as 1990. Many of us in our late 40s or early 30s romanticize the change that our generation has seen post-liberalization in 1991, that life has changed for the better. But India had seen gut-wrenching change even before that. As you can read in the two paragraphs quoted above, taken from Naipaul's conversation with Pravas, an engineer who was thinking of university education and a career in 1962. Visceral, transformative change in India happens every once in a generation. We are in the midst of one such change now. The shift of savings towards financial assets from physical assets such as gold and real estate. There is an important change that will play out for many years to come since India has come a long way to go from unremunerative and unproductive investments like real estate and gold towards equities. We set up Marcellus Investment Managers in late 2018 and our travel for the past 4 years, where we met tens of thousands of affluent Indian families and high net worth individuals, HNIs, has convinced us of this powerful generational change. We have written about this change in several publications, including Coffee Can Investing, The Low-Risk Road to Stupendous Wealth by myself, Rakshit Ranjan and Pranab Unyal in 2018, and Diamonds in the Dust, Consistent Compounding for Extraordinary Wealth Creation by myself, Rakshit Ranjan and Salil Desai in 2021. Our travel and research over most of these past few years have convinced us that the shift toward financial assets is not only inevitable but essential for Indian families to prepare themselves better for their retirement. Even the RBI, in their 2017 household survey, has warned of the deleterious effect of going into retirement laden with real estate and gold. The RBI personnel are not known to be alarmist in their use of the English language. So when they write a paragraph such as the one below, it suggests that they are really concerned about this issue. Over the coming decade and a half, the elderly cohort is expected to grow by 75%. Only a small fraction of this cohort has saved in private pension plans. Moreover, a large segment of the population of households in all age cohorts has not actively taken steps to ensure adequate financial coverage during retirement. The need to finance adequate consumption during retirement is therefore a looming issue, and when combined with the low penetration of insurance, households appear particularly vulnerable to adverse shocks later in life. What drives the preeminence of physical assets, real estate and gold, when it comes to Indian households' investments? In our book, Diamonds in the Dust, my colleagues and I bust four myths that we encountered during our meetings with HNIs, myths which we believe had driven Indian households to invest in real estate and gold. Myth 1. Gold will help me protect my wealth. Reality. This is patently wrong, since the BSE Sensex has outperformed gold in most long-term time periods. The 2017 RBI report also makes a case for reallocation of wealth from gold to other financial assets. Myth 2. Real estate will help me grow my wealth. Reality. Home prices have at best kept pace with consumer inflation. Moreover, with residential rental yields 2-3%, being far above home loan rates, 7%, there is room for home prices to correct going forward. Besides, investment in real estate is cumbersome, illiquid, and saddled with high transaction costs. Myth 3. Debt mutual funds offer decent returns with low volatility. Reality. This myth has been perpetrated by armies of salespeople who show debt fund returns as safer than equities with returns higher than fixed deposits. However, the shuttering of some prominent mutual fund schemes following investment in high-risk, low-quality paper in their debt funds has busted this myth. Myth 4. GDP growth drives the stock market. So if I or my wealth manager can time the economic cycle, I can time the stock market. Reality. As we have shown in our research, Marcellus 2019, the relationship between GDP growth and earnings growth of the NSE Nifty 50 has broken down in the recent past. The Nifty does not capture the dynamism in India's economy, considering that in the past decade, 2011 to 2020, the Nifty has lagged nominal GDP growth in terms of price performance. While the negation of these myths results in a strong case in favor of equity investments, equities also suffer from drawbacks, such as lack of good advice and dodgy products being peddled as safe. As we have explained in Diamonds in the Dust, investors in the Indian stock market need to minimize risk, such as accounting risks, revenue risks, profit risks, and liquidity risks, while investing in equities. The approach that we at Marcellus follow is the consistent compounding formula of investing in clean, well-managed Indian companies selling essential products behind very high barriers of entry. My belief in this investment approach has resulted in my investing my savings, my parents' savings, and that of several thousand Indian families whose savings Marcellus manages as per this approach. What approach should you follow depends on your priorities and goals. The last thing you want to do is get carried away with the noise of screaming TV channels and the flood of content on social media. Long-term financial planning is built to take you through life, not just the latest bull market. As we explained in Coffee Can Investing, it is important to link your investment style with your financial objectives. Otherwise, you will end up either taking unnecessary risks or undershooting your financial goals. The essential link between your investment style and your financial objective is made through financial planning. There are two ways to start your financial plan, depending on your objectives and the stage of life that you are at. For beginners, it makes sense to use the DIY approach because that helps you learn important concepts in personal finance, such as risk, return, liquidity, etc., and also sets you on the path of rigorous discipline towards retirement planning. But as you grow older and your responsibilities increase, you might need help from a professional. Indeed, most of the incorrect decisions that we make with regard to our investments usually stem from misinformed, even if well-intentioned, advice from friends, family, and social groups. Cocktail parties during bull markets tend to drive more decisions than conversations with investment professionals. And this is so prevalent that legendary fund manager Peter Lynch had a cocktail party theory that he wrote about in his seminal book, One Up on Wall Street, Lynch and Rothschild, 1989. Lynch used cocktail party conversations as indicators of forward stock market returns, starting from stage one, when no one at cocktail parties was interested in him or his profession, and hence the market was likely to turn up. All the way to stage four, when the same people would tell him what stocks he should buy, and hence an indicator that the market was due for a tumble. Lynch wrote his book in 1989, when there was no social media, and his theory, I reckon, holds true even today. As more investors enter the stock market, the urge to know how the stock market will perform is even higher. It is a futile chase. As I have written time and again, timing the market is neither feasible nor is it the primary driver of long-term investment returns. As explained in Chapter 6 of Diamonds in the Dust, titled When to Buy, once you buy clean companies that can grow earnings consistently via their competitive advantages and smart capital allocation, timing the stock price or the broader market is taken out of the equation. Using extensive research and analysis, we showed that timing the overall market is not worth the effort and surely not worth testing your luck in getting each buy and sell timing right. What matters is the quality of the stocks that you're investing in and the regularity with which you keep investing your savings in the stock market. And thankfully, with rising awareness among young Indians regarding the merits of equity investing, the idea of low-cost regular investment is gathering pace. There are three major changes here that are positive and encouraging in building a culture of investing in India. First, the Systematic Investment Plan, SIP, has exploded in popularity with the number of accounts reaching a record high. Dhawan 2022 of 5.39 crore in April 2022. SIPs are an easy way to invest regularly in the markets, and the mutual fund industry's efforts to popularize this simple product appear to have paid off.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.